Hey everyone, in this video, we're going to talk about how you can use complex numbers within Microsoft Excel. And we'll talk about how to use math operations with these complex numbers. To work with complex numbers within Microsoft Excel, we're going to use the complex function. The first thing we are going to do is understand what this function is, how we use it, and what it does. To do this, let's type equals COMP and hit tab to autocomplete. As we can see, the complex function is at the top of our autocomplete. Now, if you click on this blue complex word here for a description of our function, we will get a pop-up that describes what it does. It states that this function converts real and imaginary coefficients into a complex number of the form x plus yi or x plus yj, meaning we will give this function two parameters, one for our real component and then one for our imaginary, and the complex function will return the complex number. Below here, we see the syntax, or the way in which Excel expects us to give it our two parameters. So, that being our real coefficient, comma, and then our imaginary coefficient. Lastly, in the square brackets here, we have an optional parameter. That you only need to use if you wish to have j as your imaginary suffix instead of I. If you scroll down a bit more, you can see some additional comments about the function and some examples. But we'll go through some examples of our own right now, so let's close this function help window. So, we're asked to express the following pairings of real and imaginary values in complex terms with an I and then a j suffix. Then lastly, we'll walk through how you can add and subtract, and then multiply and divide, two complex number terms together. To express the first real and imaginary components in a complex number, let's click this cell here and type equals comp and then tab again. Now, you can see here that we also have the two parameters that we talked about earlier. It wants our real component first, so let's click that. And that'll add a comma, and our second parameter it is asking for is the imaginary portion, which will be blue here as you can see, which means it wants that as an input. Then let's hit enter, and we can see that we now have a complex number. We can now click this cell and drag down this little green circle, and it'll bring our formula down like so. Now, let's just do the same thing to get our terms with a j suffix, which is the exact same process, except after our imaginary parameter, let's add another comma and then a j in quotation marks. Then we'll just drag this formula down again, like so. Now, lastly, let's learn how to perform some math operations with these complex numbers. To add complex terms, we use the imSum function, and then just use our complex numbers as our parameters like so. Likewise, for finding the difference of complex numbers, we will use the imSub function like so. Thirdly, let's talk about how to multiply complex numbers within Microsoft Excel. Again, we'll perform a very similar calculation, however this time we'll use the imProduct function, selecting our two parameters and we receive the product of the two complex numbers. Just as a note, for all these operations, you cannot add an imaginary number with I and another with j as it'll give you an error. Lastly, let's talk about how to divide complex numbers within Microsoft Excel. Much like all our other math operations, all we need to do is call the imDiv function, select our two complex numbers as parameters, and there we go, we just divided two complex numbers. I hope that this video helped your understanding of how to enter and use complex numbers in Microsoft Excel. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, and consider checking out our YouTube memberships by clicking that join button down below. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below, and I will do my best to address your concerns.